Congress. People need to realize there are just very few negotiators that are actually trying to strike a deal on the debt limit ceiling. So what we do are other things, which are just as important. However, that vote is going to be important. It's just a wait and see as to what kind of negotiated settlement you're going to get out of the parties and the president.
To being out of politics, I miss it, and I'd be a liar if I said I didn't. Although I've found my post-governor's life to be challenging and energizing and good, it's not the same. It's like a basketball player who no longer can play the sport he loves. But on the other hand, I'm finding that because of my work with NBC, I'm still able to influence the public dynamic to a degree to participate in the national debate. And that's why I love what I do. Don't tell Phil Griffin, but I do it for a whole lot less money.
I'm Karen Finney with MSNBC. You know, I think in the case of the Keith Anthony trial, I mean, it is a newsworthy story, and it is the job of the media to be there. I think some of the behavior that we saw, like people kind of fights breaking out for the limited number of tickets in the gallery, I don't think you can blame the media for that. I mean, those individuals who made the decision to travel that distance and wait in line for those tickets kind of tells you what a frenzy there was around this case. And again, I think the media really tried to stay as focused as possible on the case itself and the merits of the case and sort of that analysis. Some elements kind of went into more of the personal stories. But again, this was an item that was, I think, newsworthy regardless, and that the media was really just there to cover it.
I wish I had, especially given the last few days and all the media frenzy, I wish I had time to pay attention to the trial. So I didn't really pay that much attention to it. There certainly was a lot of media hype about it. There was a lot of commentary. Most of the commentary proved to be wrong. And, you know, obviously the defense lawyers felt beat upon for the last 30 to 60 days as everyone was saying that they didn't know what they were doing and they're representing a guilty person. And, you know, like or love the verdict, the defense attorneys obviously did a pretty good job. Fortunately, I think that maybe a commentary on the sickness of the newspaper industry, and I think we're all bound and determined to make sure that the media industries and our content and our distribution business doesn't fall prey to the same fate. We have Chuck Todd. I don't think I missed anyone in the talent area. And I also want to acknowledge the attendance tonight of Antoine Sanfuentes, who is the head of the NBC Bureau, News Bureau here in Washington. So thank you all for joining us and for making MSNBC the extraordinary view that it is today.
With us longer than anybody else, he is the heart and soul of MSNBC.
I do love the fact that there are people, they meant this, of color and people from minorities and people that don't feel that other networks have spoken out loud about the concerns of the country. They come up to me all the time and say, we're so glad you're on television. And it's a fact. It's a heartwarming reality.
I think there is plenty of balance, certainly on MSNBC, and I'm even willing to concede that there's balance on Fox as well.